It's Password. It's Super Password. Our special guest this week, Betty White and Vicki Lawrence. And the star of Super Password, Bert Convy.
Everybody, thank you so much. I thank you, and welcome to Super Password. It is great to have you with us. It's great to have you all. What were you talking about that was so... What was that all about back there?
Well, we were talking about the magic of television, and as the set comes rolling in and it looks so great on TV, there's three guys over here heaving away.
It's hernia time in Dixie.
No, we've talked about, we give the impression that this is so mechanized and hydraulic things are going, and there's three guys that...
Three of the nicest hydraulics I've ever
seen. You shouldn't tell them that. It breaks the illusion. They think it's all magic and it moves in place nicely, you see.
It does, because you got three good hydraulics over there.
Okay. Well, what'd you do last night?
Well, last night I just kind of stayed home, sat in front of the fire for a while, roasted some marshmallows.
Yeah, well, that's a nice thing to do. Mm-hmm.
In June?
Yes. Don't question. Don't question
the calendar. Calendar's slow.
How about you, Vicki? How's Big Al, and what did you do last night?
Al's good. Al's great. Kids
He's
are great.
I've heard. Yeah.
Be out
Never
of school
mind.
Soon.
She doesn't know that for sure. She just, that's a figure.
She's heard. I heard her say she's heard.
And what did you do? Did you just have a fire also or no?
No, not in June. We don't have fires. It was a little foggy.
See, if you live down by the water, it gets chilly at night.
It does in June.
What did I do last night?
You got that laryngitis again, don't you?
Yeah, it's hanging on. Probably be here.
It's funny that it would last 3 days like that.
Yeah, really?
I'm working on it. I'm going to turn into a tea bag if I have any more hot tea and lemon. And before this gets to be a miniseries in its own, let's bring out our players, shall we? Here comes Belinda and David.
Hi, David.
Hi, Ken. We'll get back to you in a moment, champ. Right now, let's talk to the challenger, David. David, welcome again, sir.
Hi.
Tell us about yourself again, sir, if you will.
I'm David Ryan. I'm an assistant manager for a major airline here, assistant manager of flight attendants. In my spare time, I do a lot of traveling, especially between the West Coast and Hawaii. And I'd just like to say hello to two of my great office workers who are watching this morning, hoping I win some money so I can take them out to dinner. And that's Ed and Ethel.
Ed and Ethel are watching.
Sounds like a comedy team. But,
yeah, Ethel and Ed. Ethel and Fred has been done, but Ed and Ethel hasn't been done. Well, okay. Well, good luck, and I hope you
Thank
do.
You.
You're going to take them to dinner?
Yeah.
Yeah.
They
well,
get
you
to
could,
name the place, so...
They get to name the place?
Yeah.
But you could already
Whoa.
Do it. You've already got $400.
It could be in Paris or something.
Ah, hold it. That's the way it could. He can fly there.
Don't give him any
ideas.
Yeah,
if you want to go to dinner, Regine's, please.
Okay. Moving right along.
Dennis is real good.
He can afford anything at the moment, but here's somebody who can afford dinner any place in the world, is Belinda, our champion. Tell us, because you now have $7,900.
I do. Nice.
Tell us about your loan leasing place once.
Well, first I'll tell you my name. It's Belinda Beasley.
Okay.
And before I was in loan leasing, I was in immunology.
You were?
Yes. Well, in New Haven, Connecticut. I did research there.
Is that right?
Yeah.
What were you working on mostly?
I was working on, I made hybrid cells.
Hybrid cells?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, I was researching cancer.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And it's like a new technique to study the way cells interact and...
Well, that's fascinating.
Response.
That's a wonderful thing.
Yeah, isn't that
thing.
Neat?
Yes,
it's hard to describe
bet.
In one line.
It is, yeah.
Yeah, I didn't, yeah. I'm
no,
right.
You did that very well.
Yeah.
I even understood it. And so if I understood it, anybody can. If you're ready to go, if you're ready to play, gang, let's do it, shall we? Belinda and David, you'll be giving the clues at the moment. Take a look at your first word. The folks at home will do the same thing. There it is. Belinda, lead us off.
Lennon.
John.
Exactly.
Perfect. Thank you.
Oh, it's just so obvious.
John,
I mean, yeah, I hate to just
only
go
be
for
one
the
thing.
Easy one, certainly. Hooker.
Is.
Oh, Betty.
Isn't that funny? Now, that's the one that never occurred to me, I must say. Is it Hooker?
Shouldn't have eaten those marshmallows last night.
Yeah.
It's gone to your brain.
The smoke from the fireplace probably got to you a little bit, too. Here comes the next word, please. There it is. Okay, Belinda.
McCartney.
Paul.
By the way, I don't know if I ever said it, but this is the $400 puzzle, and this will decide the game if you get it, Betty. It's now John and Paul for the game.
Is it the Beatles?
Is it the Beatles?
Oh, phooey.
Well, it could have been the Beatles.
It sure could.
Well, it's half of the Beatles anyway. Okay, here we go. Next word, please. Okay. Belinda?
Me.
Engagement
ring.
Yes, exactly. Very good, great. Okay, for the game, once again, we have John, Paul, and ring. And if you get this, Belinda will win.
Oh, and it isn't the Beatles. I'll be darned. John, Paul, ring. Oh, would you like
do you know
to
VICKI?
Here?
VICKI just passed
Mom's
out.
Mom's taking a nap.
Do you know that with this?
I think I do.
You think you know? How about you, David? Do you know?
No.
David doesn't. Well, that one of us here knows.
It doesn't do a lot of good when you're sitting here doing nothing.
Well, you may get a chance now. Here comes the next word, please.
Oh.
And there it is. Belinda?
Ha. Protestant?
Catholic.
Yes. John, Paul, ring, and Catholic for the game. Betty?
Is it the Pope?
Is it the Pope? Yes, it is. You're absolutely right. I love the last clue up there, boss, it said. Okay, congratulations to you again, Belinda. And David, you got $400. I think that qualifies for dinner, but the heck with them.
I had a wonderful time. It's a great group here.
Thank you for being with us. Nice to meet you. We'll come back and play the Super Password for $5,000 right after this message. Here we go. We're back. You know, I would never get to see friends if it wasn't for this show.
Isn't that the truth? This is
nice.
The only time we get to visit.
So we do. We get to visit a little bit anyway. If you're ready to go, Belinda, second time over here, you know how do we do this. I'm going to give you 10 words beginning with the letter A and continuing through the letter J, okay? A through J. Everyone you get right, I'll give you $100. If you get them all, I'll give you another $5,000.
Okay.
All set?
Yeah.
Okay, here's your squeeze for good luck. You too. Not for good luck, though. Okay, here we go. 60 seconds, right, Betty? Let's see your first word, please. And there it is. We haven't started yet. Hang on a second.
Oh, sorry,
Okay. Here we go.
Sorry, I was in the chute.
That's okay. Ready? And go.
Holland. City.
Dutch.
Pass.
B.
Boast.
Brag.
C.
Window. Pass.
D.
Sketch.
Draw.
E.
Joint.
Elbow.
F.
Monster.
Frankenstein.
G.
Venice. Boat.
Gondola.
H.
Angel.
Harp.
Ahead.
Heaven. A halo.
I.
Phony.
Insincere.
Pass.
J.
Poke.
Jab.
Okay. All right. Holland.
Antwerp.
City. Windmills.
Amsterdam.
Yes.
C.
See through.
Sheer. Oh, so. Phooey, I didn't do so good on that.
Oh, you did fine. You got 8 out of 10. Only thing I could.
There's
a very good clues.
There's a perfect clue for clearing.
The only one I could think of was foggy. Baby clear.
Oh, you said sheer, didn't you?
Yeah. And
I said sheer.
I was very hard. Impression.
All I could think of, I was trying to think
little,
of Richard.
Rich Little.
Rich Little, and I thought both of those mean something else, and that would throw us
synthetic or no.
It's ersatz, phony.
Copy, copy's good. It's imitation.
Rhinestone.
Oh. That's a very hard word. There is no real definitive clue for that.
Sweetie.
You did very well.
That's okay.
No, you did fine, and she can come back again, you know.
Yes.
You got 8 words. We'll see. You got 8 words, $800 added to your total, making it now worth, to you, you have at this moment $9,100.
I do.
That's not too shabby.
Not too shabby. We'll come back in a moment. Next time, Super Crash will be worth $5,000 more or $10,000, and we'll come back after this commercial message, and maybe it will be you. In a minute. Really fine.
Oh, yeah. No, it was a
yourself. We have been rehashing with the best clues we could come up with for I. Imitation was hard. Copy, those things.
Copy would have been perfect. But
I'm not so sure, though. I don't think there is. There's not really mimic. One word that gives it to you. Mimic, yes, but not in...
I thought a rich little, but those both mean other things, you know?
Oh, for sure. Howard says, how about the sincerest form of flattery? That's a good one.
Why didn't I think of it?
All right, Belinda, you're doing fine. You have $9,100, not so bad. And here comes your new challenger, Gary. Come on in, Gary.
Thank you.
Tell us about yourself, won't you?
My name is Gary Perez. I've recently come to God. I'm sweating. That's about it.
Are you a little nervous, Gary?
No,
not at all. Okay, all right. You want to tell us anything else or nothing else?
I think it's best left unsaid at this point.
What, we got a CIA agent here?
Hitman.
Yeah. Actually,
good luck, honey. Yeah. You need me? Just holler.
Okay.
Well, Gary, it's best, though, if you don't keep your clues a secret, okay?
I'll try and
get that out when you can, okay?
Okay?
All right, and good luck to you. I hope we're all okay. Do you think we're in trouble if we say something wrong? Yes, possibly. Okay, moving right along. Here comes the first word. Vicki and Betty will give the clues. And if you're ready, Vicki, you'll give the voice. There's the word at home, please. Vicki?
Audio.
Video.
Very nice.
That's right.
We have video, Mr. Perez.
Is it MTV?
Is it MTV? You didn't need music, jockeys, cable, station. That's why you didn't want to talk about yourself. You just want to get on with the game. I don't blame you. Okay. Move the monitors out to our players, if you will, gang.
That's
and we'll
easy.
Continue with the $200 puzzle. Whoever wins this gets a chance at the cash word worth $1,000. If you're ready. Boy, that was fast, wasn't it? Here we go. There's the word. Belinda, it's your clue.
Bothersome.
Annoying.
That's it. What happened? Okay, there it is. We have annoying. Ready?
Is it a bee?
Is it a bee? It's
not a bee. I heard it buzz.
Oh, I love it. You're so fast. I heard you were fast. Anyway, okay, moving right along. Go, bling, bang. Where's our snare drum when we need it? There's the word. Belinda, please.
Rumble.
Roar.
No. Gary?
Massage.
Vibrate.
Form of the word. Vicki?
Vibrator.
Motion.
Vibration.
Yes. We have annoying vibration.
Is an earthquake.
Yeah, good. Is it an earthquake?
Or is it a
moon? Oh, not that. I thought
it was
for sure it was what it was going to be. Okay, next word, please, if you're ready. Here it comes. There it is. Belinda, you're still up.
Inhaling.
Breathing.
Exactly. Annoying, vibration, and breathing.
Is it snoring?
Ooh, is it snoring? Yes, great. That is great. Okay. The score is now 200 for Belinda and 100 for Gary. And it's your turn for the first time this week to play with the magic toaster. Our cash word, which
Vicki's
is worth, yes,
yeah,
worth
really.
$1,000. And if you know how we do this, Betty, you have 3 chances to communicate the word to Belinda. Take a look in there. We'll show everybody at home what the cash word is for today. There it is. Okay, off you go. We're ready for clue number 1.
Gun.
Rifle.
Clue number 2.
Handle. Trigger.
Clue number three.
Mark.
Oh, it's good clues. Perfect clues.
That's a terrible
when you put a mark
word.
On the handle of your gun, what is that?
A notch.
That's correct.
Oh, well, I got it.
Not so fast, Belinda. Sorry about that. Sorry about you, but you were right there. It was close. Perfect clues. It just wasn't the right time. Tomorrow you'll get notch. Okay, next time the cash will be worth $2,000. And with our score, 200 for Belinda and 100 for Gary, we will change partners, okay? And we'll break away for tomorrow. Okay. We are definitely back. This is definitely the $300 puzzle. And if you're ready to go, Betty and Vicky will be giving the clues. Take a look in your little television. You like that little television?
I'm going to take this one home. She wants the toaster, and I get this.
Okay, I think that's fair. Here comes your word. There it is. And Betty, lead us off, please.
Oh, dear. Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, Betts.
Chef. Connoisseur.
Okay. Betty?
Galloping.
Gourmet.
Yes, very nice. You stumbled through that very well. Okay, gourmet is the word. Gary, you need this to stay in the game.
Vincent Price.
Is it Vincent Price?
Could be.
No, that's a very good guess, because he certainly is a gourmet, and a raconteur as well, and a nifty dancer. Okay, here we go. Next word, it's the rhythm of the thing. I have nothing there. Here we go.
Didn't have a K in it.
No, didn't have a K or a cookie or a gorilla. There it is, Betty. Please.
Complainer.
Whiner.
No. Vicky.
Sickly.
Moaner.
Okay, now, Betty.
Psychosomatic.
Hypochondria.
Exactly. Well, perfect clue. Great clue.
Yeah, good
one. Gourmet, hypochondriac, eh?
I don't want to insult anybody. Got me there.
And you didn't.
No.
Okay, here we go. Next word, please. Anybody up here have an idea? Only hypochondriac comes to mind. Here we go. There it is, Betty.
Cameraman.
Photographer.
Yes. Excellent. Those are great clues and great answers. Gourmet, hypochondriac, and photographer. And you need this, Gary.
Is it an apron?
Is it an apron? Is it an apron? Okay. That's not bad. Here we go.
Good.
Well, but it's there. Boy, I knew it. Isn't that funny? Here we go, Betty.
Felix?
Oscar.
Yes.
Oh. Thank you, John.
Gourmet, hypochondriac, photographer, and Oscar Gary.
Tony Randall.
Is it Tony Randall? Well, now, it might be what I thought originally. I can't imagine that it is because it's fairly obscure, but let's see what it is. Okay. Moving on. Last word coming up. This is your last clue. Here it comes. Betty, please.
Border.
Roommate.
Yes. He said it. How did he get that?
How did he do that? I was playing defensively.
I can't believe you got that. All right, we have gourmet, hypochondriac, photographer, Oscar roommate.
It better be Felix Unger.
Is it Felix Unger?
Yeah, Felix.
Yes, it is. I don't know how you got that. Okay. It's not over yet, gang. You never even got in there, but it's not over yet because now comes the $400 puzzle. That is right after this commercial message. We'll be right back. Don't go away.
Because of a technical problem, the fourth puzzle was replaced and the program edited. This is Gene Woods speaking for Super Password, a Mark Goodson television production.